Scuttlebutt here. In this video, I'm going to be changing the coils and the spark plugs on this 2005 Mazda MPV. This is the 3-liter V6, and the thing that makes it a challenge is the cylinders 1, 2, and 3 are behind all this. They're back behind all that. So basically, you've got to remove the intake manifold in order to get to them. So that is the challenge on this whole thing. If it wasn't for that, it'd be nothing. But I will show you how to do this. And I will tell you, I want to give some credit to mpvclub.com. If you have projects on these vans and have questions, check them out. They've got a lot of good information. This is a 2005, but it's the base. 2002 and newer are all very similar, with the 2004 and 5 having one extra step, which we'll obviously have since this is a 5. So first thing, safety. I want to cover some safety. So, you know, be safe when you work on these things. I will be removing the battery. You don't technically have to remove the battery, but you definitely want to remove the negative battery cable no matter what. I'm going to remove the whole battery because it's just easier to get to stuff. Also, I'm going to be using compressed air to blow any dirt or debris that I can out from the valley of the where the cylinder or the spark plugs are, coils. So wear safety glasses, and I do suggest wearing gloves at least for the parts where you're trying to break a bolt loose, so you don't, you know, if you slam something with your hand, it won't it'll do less damage. So you'll probably see me with and without gloves at different points. But all right, so also before you start, probably after you take the cover off though, take pictures so you know where everything goes. I mean, the video here will be here, and you can probably find some pictures on the internet, but I always recommend take pictures before you take stuff apart. And I will be, I'll list the tools that I used in the comments and the info, and I may even insert something right here. So these are the tools you'll need. You're gonna need some pliers, a flathead screwdriver, a Phillips screwdriver, some extensions, socket, 8, 10, and 12 millimeter open-end wrenches, sockets, both, a spark plug socket, I think it's 5/8, you'll want to check that, a torque wrench, and of course you'll want plugs and coils to replace those. These are the plugs that I'm putting in. I like NGKs. These are the old coils. Yeah, this is at the end of the video because I know what I use now. Those are the old coils. You may or may not use the same plugs, the same coils. Mine's a 2005 MPV, 3-liter. Double check yours, make sure that you get the right coils and spark plugs. One other thing is don't lose any bolts. Don't drop them, or any gaskets. Make sure they don't drop. So I'm gonna get started. First thing I have is the cover. I'm gonna remove the cover first because I've already loosened it. It takes a little eight mil nuts. You may need a extension to get down into some of these locations. I do recommend, this is one of my favorite tools right here. It is a magnet on the end of it, and it extends. And voila, you can pull that thing right out of there. It also is useful to when you're working back, like on the EGR valve, having this thing back in there so that it'll catch any gasket. It's a metal gasket back there. It'll catch it if it falls. And then I will tell you that one of the things that prompted this is I got a check engine light, and it was 403, which is EGR valve. I removed this and cleaned it out, tested the resistance between the connections. Everything read fine. Put it back on. It ran great for unchecked all the vacuum lines, that kind of thing. Ran great for a few hundred miles. Then came on, and then not only did it come on, it's the light come on, it started missing. So it's got 102,000 miles on it, and one of the things that, you know, these plugs, these iridium plugs, are great, and they're supposed to last 100,000. I got 102,000. I'm gonna go ahead and replace them, and since I'm doing all this work, I'm replacing the coils also. I will tell you, on the coils, shop around on the coils, because I have seen them as high as $200 each, which is outrageous, and I have seen them as cheap as like $60 for all six. Now, understand, that's probably a pretty generic coil, may not last as long, but you know, it's your budget, and you'll know how long you'll want it to last and how much money you got to spend. So, you know, me, I tend to go kind of in the middle cheap range, because I'm not paying $200 a piece. Like I said, that is just robbery right there. So, you know, I buy a pack of six for $100 or so, you know, and obviously make your own decision, do your own research. But these were like 4.5-star reviewed by a lot of people, so I feel pretty comfortable with them. All right, this is your throttle cable right here. To get this, well, to help get it out of the way of this, we're gonna pinch on both sides and push towards the back of the van. That'll loosen it. You can then start pulling this up. And sorry, I'm having to hold the camera and do all this myself, which is makes it a little poor camera work. I am going to take the oil cap off. Do not get dirt falling in there. Da, da, da. All right, I think I'm going to go. Wow, this is really hard with one hand. Okay, I'll be back. All right, cover's off. Now I'm going to use a 10 mil to first remove the negative battery cable. Once I've removed the negative, I will remove the positive. This should actually be down until I have the negative off. That way you won't accidentally short them. So I'm going to remove negative, pull it off out of the way. Then I'm going to remove positive, and then I will loosen up these so I can actually pull the battery out. So the battery's out, and next that I'm going to do, and I mean, you can do these in a lot of different orders, but this is how I'm going to do it. And looking at this, I'm going to remove this bracket. Trying to see if it's better to remove the bracket or unhook those. I think I'm just going to unbolt the bracket. And then this bracket, there's two bolts, one bolt. Now, that's going to get it where these are loose. Pay attention here. I'll try to cover this in the video, but pay attention to how these connect. They're not hard, but you don't want to tear them up either. But once I get these loose, that'll give me enough free play so I can easily pull those off of the throttle body. So something that I do is I actually put the bolts back in the holes. You'll notice that I put those back in, that way I'm not going to lose them, and I know something should be there. Also on the battery clamp, that one's there. So on these, this piece, now that you can see the inside, all it does is snaps on and out. So to put it on, you just push it up. Obviously, you got to hold that. To pull it off, you just slide it straight out. It'll unclamp. The throttle control, once you have it loose, I hope I can get these, show this right. You pull it down, and it's a lot easier when you have two hands. You pull it down and out. So then now I can take this, I can pull it out of the way, hopefully not scratch the van. But it's out of my way now. Do not bend, crank, you know, any, don't mess these up. But this gives you a little better view of what we're getting into. Next, I'm looking here. I gotta do that. I'm actually thinking I may start with the stuff in the back. There's a power steering hose, and it has a clamp. I hope you can see where my hand is. There's a clamp right here that holds it in place with a bolt on each side. We're gonna wanna remove those. It's probably also a 10 mil so far. Everything is 10 mil, except for the cover was 8. There's also the dreaded positive crankcase ventilation PCV valve hose way back here. There's a clamp. If you've seen my video on replacing that, you know it's a bear. There's a clamp. I hope you can see it, but my finger right there. There's a clamp. You'll have to unclamp that somehow. And then there's also another hose that goes in the back. You'll be able to see it better once I get it out, but there's those two. Let me see if you can see it from this side. Right here. You gotta pull that one out. I think that this one is easier. Anyway, I'm gonna pull those out. Those are those three things. Those are the hardest to get to. And then I'll start on the EGR valve. And go from there. So I got those off, and the bracket that holds the power steering cable was like so, I'm guessing. There's actually only one bolt, just the one, and it's on the rider side, 10 mil. The top vacuum line just pulls out. The PCV valve is got a clamp, so you gotta get a pair of pliers. I used a pair of, I always call them channel locks, on middle setting. Reached with my right arm in there, threading it through, got the clamp on, used my left to work the thing loose. It's a pain, but it will come off. And now, okay, on the over here, I have disconnected electric there. I am now gonna start disconnecting all of these, anything that's connected from the wiring harness will need to be removed. It'll have to be disconnected. Some, like the one back here for the EGR, will have the wire. Man, it's hard to work the camera with this, but it has a little piece that plugs into the, holds it to the manifold. You're going to want to pull that out. Throttle body sensor. That's got to come off somehow. There it goes. It's on the back. So you pull those out. Technically, these don't have to, because you will have to undo that, which is I think that'll be my next step, is to remove, just pull the air tube, whatever it's called, off of the throttle body, and that's a Phillips head. So I loosened the clamp, I loosened that clamp, but this thing is so short that I can turn it, but it's a real pain. I mean, I can get a flathead. What you can do is get a flathead and pry here, and that'll help. But, and I removed this, went ahead and removed this. But what I'm going to do, just to make it easier, there's 4 10 mil bolts right here that hold the mass airflow sensor body, I don't know what you call it, to the airbox. You can pull those 10 off, those 10 mils off. There's 4 of them. There is a gasket right there between them. Don't destroy your gasket, but I went ahead and unbolted that, and what I'll do, this will give me plenty of free space. I'll get my flathead and pry this away, and that'll whole piece will come out and just be out of my way. You still got it connected here, but that's how I'm gonna do it. So I've done a little more work. The this hose goes to the power brakes. This clamp, if you'll notice, it's got teeth on both sides, top and bottom. And it'll just slide in, and what you got to do is carefully pull down on the two, separate them a little bit, and it will pull up, it'll open. This piece was really weird to get off. I was going to pull the hose off, and then at one point I lifted up and it just popped right out. But what's funny is I put it back in and tried it again, and sometimes it wouldn't come out, other times it would only come out halfway. But then it, like I said, I don't know. I'm not sure what to tell you on that one. Work on it, it will come out, just don't break it. You can always pull the hose off, but mine was really stuck. So I got that out of the way. This is a 10 mil nut. I am going to go ahead and take it off because I just want it out of my way. So now, if you'll notice, I have pretty much everything's off except EGR valve, which I'll need to use maybe 12. I'm thinking 12, so I don't remember. Here, pull this vacuum line off like so. Unbolt that. There is a gasket here, so don't lose the gasket. Disconnect. I already disconnected it. That's why it's not coming off. Okay. Yes, I'm good. There's a gasket right there, though. Okay, and on this one, 4s and 5s, 2000 4s and 5s, have these hoses right here, and they're supposed to be like water coolant. So I'm going to have, there's one on the front. There's another one on the back, right here. I'm going to pull those off. And hopefully I won't get coolant all over the place, but we'll see. EGR valve is loose. This is what the gasket looked like. I labeled it outside, inside. There is still, in the back of this, is the a metal hull, metal line that goes down to the exhaust. I am going to try to avoid removing that if I can. And it is loose, you can see. The water lines, I got this one completely off. I will tell you, you will lose a little bit of fluid, not much. I have it sitting here and pointing up so that the fluid does not run out. You can see a little bit came out. The back one is right here. Can you see that? I hope you can see that. I will give you a hint on these lines. Okay, here's a tip. Don't pull on the lines to try to loosen them. When you pull, it's kind of, you know, that the what we call Chinese finger traps, whatever, where you put them on your fingers and then you pull and they tighten. Well, hoses are the same way. Don't pull and expect it to come loose, because it won't. It's going to tighten. Take the clamp off. Then with the hose, turn the hose like so. You want to twist it to break it loose from here. You may have to use a pair of pliers to twist it to break it loose. Then put a screwdriver, flathead, right here, and start pushing it down. That actually causes the hose to expand. And this one back here is not completely off. I was actually going to show you, because what I did is I got a flathead screwdriver. Once the clamp was off, put it down here, and I started prying it off like so. And like I said, I had already broke it loose twisting it. So, and it came right off. And when I pull it all the way off, you will see, I'm hoping you'll see, some fluid will probably come out. Heh, figures. Apparently it's already out. So, no fluid came out on that one, just the front one. That your mileage may vary on that. So that's loose. Now everything is loose from the intake. Next step. You have four bolts right here on the intake, and you can see they're the higher bolts. They're on the intake. There's one back here, and there's one over here. So there's a total of six on the intake manifold. And these are, I believe, 10s. Wow, they are not 10s. They appear to be 8s. And I don't have I put my 8 back. See what happens when you put your tools back? You end up with the wrong sizes. Kidding. My wife complains about me not putting my tools back. So let me get an 8 mil. Use a socket, 8 mil with an extension. And I'm going to break all of them loose. Not take them out yet. And then I'll take these out. Then I'll take these two out. And this will probably lean towards the back. Tend to tip backwards is my guess. And then we'll see where... Oh, there's still... Yeah, I think there's still two vacuum lines that you can't get to underneath. We'll find out. All right. Woo! Yeah, it's fun. Okay. I will tell you right now, if your hammies aren't stretched out when you start, they will be by the time you get to this point, leaning over this thing. Wow. My hamstrings are being stretched big time. So, there's a bracket right here. There's a 10 mil bolt that you got to take off from down here to loosen that bracket. There's another bracket. Remember where the power steering line came through and there was that clamp that holds it on that was on the rider side? Well, right to the driver's side of it, there is an 8 mil that is on a brace which connects to the intake. That's got to come out. And then on the right side, the driver's side, right down here, I probably can't get the camera in there very well, but right here there's a bracket with an 8 mil bolt. You got to take all three of those off. Now I ended up putting the bolts back in here to keep it from tipping back. And these are just little 8 mils. I do have the torque specs. I'll post that. So far, the only thing, you know, I mentioned the magnet and catching stuff. The only thing that, you know, like this has a washer, but it's not going to come off the bolt. So the only thing that's been may have fallen is the gasket, which from the EGR valve. So far, you know, all the bolts and stuff are self-contained in one way or another. So everything's now off, I'm pretty sure. You can see I can now move this. I'm gonna put the camera down and I'm gonna carefully, I may have to get another person to help. I'm gonna carefully lift up. There are intake gaskets under here that I'm gonna try to reuse. If I can, if I can't, we'll replace them, but I'm gonna try to carefully lift this up and I wanna check. I think there's some vacuum lines still under there. So I'll let you know. Ladies and gentlemen, we have successfully removed the intake manifold. Whew. I did have to, there are, as I thought, two vacuum lines right here. These two connect underneath, one on each side of underneath the throttle body area, and they're a bit of a pain to get to. I had to get someone to hold this end of the manifold up while I broke those loose. But it is separated. So here are your, this is cylinder 1, 2, 3. These are your coils. Underneath your coils will be your spark plugs. Here is your cylinder, I believe it's 4, 5, 6, yeah. So what we'll be doing is disconnecting your coil packs. And then there's a 8 mil bolt that hold these in. And so we'll remove those, pull those out, and we'll do front and back bolts. Piece of advice right here, that's part of your intake runners. Do not drop anything in there. Do not drop anything in there. That is a direct passage right into your valves and cylinders. If you drop something in there and then you try to start it, you're going to do some major damage. So that being said, take a cloth or tape, and maybe tape. I don't know about the tape. Take a rag and cover them. I will grab another rag for the back ones. Cover those. Don't get anything in them. And over here is the intake. This is the bottom. Remember those lines, vacuum lines, they go right here. There is your intake runners. I am going to wow, they're not bad at all. I'm still going to probably clean them. There's where your PCV valve goes, that other vacuum that's in the back. There is your EGR valve where it connects. I am going to clean this. It's really not that dirty. But I'm going to clean it out really well while I got it off. I'm going to really clean this up while I got access. Your throttle body, use only approved throttle body cleaner for that. This is your EGR valve. Again, I've already cleaned it. The code still came on. Just disappointing because those things are like $180 for a new one, and I had tested it and I don't think it's the valve, and I don't think it's the solenoid on top. It's moving, and I checked the resistance on it and it was within spec. 20 ohms, I think, between the right ones, the correct ones. So I'm gonna, well, I've got all this out, I'm gonna, like I said, do some extra cleaning. Oh, if you need to replace your that dreaded PCV hose, there's your PCV valve right here. Right here. And this is that hose. This is the new one that is better made. If you need to, if you still got the original on there and you go this far, go ahead and replace those. Trust me. Let's see. Anything else while we're here? I don't think so. So I'm gonna cover that back bank up, clean my stuff, then I'll start pulling those coil packs off. As you can see, I have covered the intake both sides. I have removed, oh, come on light, there you go. This is the coil pack. Slides in the hole like so, and then snaps on top of the spark plug. You will remove, push down on that tab at the end, pull it out, unscrew, unbolt this, and you will pull it out like so. I happen to number mine just because I'm that way. You will then use a unknown size spark plug wrench. I think this is a 5/8, and an extension. This will go down into the holes there, and you will use your wrench to break them loose. All right. Here is the plug that came out of it. What I find interesting is it's pretty worn, but it's also says platinum. I could have swore that these were iridium. That word. Iridium, there you go. So anyway, they're only platinum. The fact that they lasted 100,000 is amazing. And honestly, I mean, we take care of this van, obviously. The intake was, it had some black residue on the edges, on the surfaces, but it was clean. The EGR valve area, that was all clean. We do a fair bit of highway driving with it, which helps. And it was in really good shape. I am shocked though that I could have swore those were iridium. But they lasted 100,000, 102,000 miles. The new ones are iridium, probably overkill. but they'll last at least another 100,000. So yeah, the gap is in the owner's manual, but it is 0.051 to 0.057, or 1 inches, or 1.3 to 1.4 millimeters, whichever you use. Be sure to check your gap. This one is the old one is worn, and it's at like 55. Yeah, that's not helping at all, is it? Yeah. It's pretty worn. The new one is currently set at 57. I may knock that in, just, I don't know. I haven't decided. It's at the high range of the gap, which is fine. So I may just leave it. But those are your spark plugs. Your coils, here is my new coil pack. Yes, made in China. I hated that, but it is the correct one. And if you need a number off of my coil packs, that's the number. So I'm going to be, it's also a good idea to use some anti-seize. These are aluminum heads, so you'll probably want to, I'm pretty sure they're aluminum heads, so you'll probably want to use some anti-seize on the spark plug threads. That way in 100,000 miles when you're trying to get them off, they won't actually be stuck into the metal. But putting them back in is really simple. It's the same way, you just, it's just the opposite way. The thing about a spark plug socket is it's got a piece of rubber in the bottom, so when you put your plug in, don't fall on me, it'll hold it. That's why it's a spark plug socket. And then you'll just slide it down in the hole. Make sure you don't cross thread. I recommend when you put it down in there, don't use the wrench to start it. Just use your hands on the extension, turn it backwards some, and then start turning it forward until you get it started. Hand tighten it and then put the wrench on. That way you're not going to worry, that way you don't have to worry about cross threading. But the front ones are obviously easy to get to. Back ones are not too bad now that you've got the intake off. So I'm going to go ahead and replace them. Alright, I got my spark plugs in. I did find a couple were cracked, but I'm thinking that might have been with me getting them out. Piece of advice, when you're tightening your plugs, so, like I told you, start them by hand, and then keep this centered as much as you can. Do not push pressure to the side. When you're pulling them out, you know, it doesn't matter if you're cracking them, if you're going to throw them away. But when you're tightening them, keep this as straight as you can. Don't put pressure to the side, because you can crack the porcelain bit right here, and then you will have issues. The other thing I want to show you, this was the number 3, and I don't know if this is going to show up real well, but that gap is over 70 thousandths. In fact, I think it was over 90 thousandths, which is almost twice what it should have been. And you can see right there that it's kind of, it's no longer pointed. It's been flattened, and I'm wondering if maybe there was some detonation on this one. It doesn't look like detonation, but something, for some reason, this plug is the number 3. Wait a minute. That's why I write them right on it. Yeah, this is number 3. And this is the one that was the worst. All the others were at most 60 thousandths, which is more than what it should be, but then they're 102,000 miles old. This one is way out, so definitely glad I am replacing these. So plugs are in, now I will put the coil packs in, and the coil packs are very simple. Of course I didn't have them here, so you take your coil pack. And it's just like when you pulled them out, you set them here, line the bolt holes up, and just push straight down. You'll push straight down on them, on this, and then you'll bolt it in and plug it in. And that should be all there is to it. So the coils are now on. Of course, the new spark plugs are in. Torque numbers, so you know how tight to make these things. I hope that's showing. Your intake's going to be 6 to 9 foot-pounds. EGR valve, and that's an 8 mil. EGR valve is 14 to 19 foot-pounds. It's a 12 mil bolt. The others are 6 to 8, because most of those are 8. So anytime you got an 8 mil bolt, usually it's going to be somewhere 6 to 8, 69 foot pounds. So it's not over tight, but it ain't loose either. So bear that in mind. I have taken and made sure that there are no cuts or gouges in the gasket. So those are all good. By the way, here's your fuel injectors. If you ever have to replace those, that's where they are. And now I'll show you the intake. I got these nice and clean. These are all nice and clean. You want that. So we got a good seal. And the throttle body is now spotless. EGR valve where it goes in is very clean. It was not dirty before, but it's even cleaner now. So that's that. And now the fun part will be putting it back on and reconnecting everything. When you are putting this on top of the engine, I suggest having someone else help you get it centered so that you get the gaskets in the right position. They shouldn't move, but if you set this on it and then slide it, they could move on you. So keep an eye on that. Okay, so it's setting on top again. You do just the opposite of taking it off. You put it in place. You got to get those two vacuum lines that are underneath. Then I started the six intake manifold bolts. You can see they're not tight. Then go to the bolt that's back here on this brace. Do that one next. Put it in, not tight. Then I did the back one. Again, it's in but not tight. And then I did this one. This one is, the brace will move, so it's not a big deal, but it's in, not tight. So now everything that holds it in place is in, the bolts are in their spots. I can now go and tighten stuff up. On the intake, again, intake bolts, 6 to 9 foot-pounds, or it's hard to tell if this is showing in the camera, or 72 to 105 inch pounds. They're only 8 mil bolts, so tighten this and this. When you tighten gasket stuff, generally you want it to go from the inside out and do it at increments. So in other words, don't go to 100 first. So this says 72, so I'd go to about 60. Do these to first finger tighten them. Tighten those to 60 inch pounds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's what I would do to 60. Then I'd go to like 80. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then I would go to your 100. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, that's how you want to tighten those. Then I'd go to that back one, or the side one, back one, then that one. That one there is actually a 10 mil, so you could make it a little tighter, but I don't think you're going to get a torque wrench back there anyway. So just put them in, don't over tighten, but make sure they're good and snug. And then we will start connecting all the rest of it, including hooking up all those nice stuff in the back. I think I'll do that as soon as I tighten it. I'll then go for the back stuff, which is hard to reach. All right, so I want to show you, I've got all these connected. I've got the hoses connected. There was the vacuum ones that are underneath. There's the water ones, coolant, on each side underneath the throttle body. There are the connectors that are back in place. EGR valve is back in place and connected. This bracket's back in place. The vacuum hose from the brake booster is back in place. Over here, the connection to the, I forget what it's called, on this side is back in place. It is tight. Now I'm going to connect this throttle cable back to the throttle body before I connect it here again. The way you do it to wrap it around, don't twist it. Slide, there's a little slot. Slide it, bring it back up, and it's right there again. This one, you put here, and you just snap it there. Okay, that's how you do that. They're not hard, don't let it intimidate you, but don't twist them and don't crease them. And then see, this will go right like so, and they become tight. So there's how you do that. I'm gonna finish putting these brackets back in place. Brackets in place. Throttle body works. So I put the air hose back on, and then here's that gasket. It will only go one way because there's a tab here and a tab here. So what you have to do is pull this away a little bit and then slide this on. Wow. Okay, get it in the camera. Slide this back, put that in there, line up your tabs, and then put your bolts in. So once I got this on, bolted up, I slide that in, then I bolt that up, tighten the clamp, connect the hose. I then put the battery in, tighten it. I then connect that one and then the mass airflow sensor. Make sure all these are connected. I double check everything. Make sure I got all my lines in, all my cables run correctly. Check all your bolts. Make sure you didn't forget anything. I find it helps if you use a flashlight so you can see better. And then the last thing I will do is connect that negative battery cable. And it started right up and is purring like a kitten. Wow, it's running much smoother. That number 3 plug was really worn out. And a couple were cracked, but I think I cracked them getting them out. So there you go. Keep your hands, see that pulley, don't get your hands in there. There's some on the left side. But listen for vacuum leaks. And what I'm gonna be doing is taking it for a drive. When I get back, I'm gonna recheck the torque on the intake manifold bolts. So I'm gonna let it heat up and then I'll recheck that. But it's running really smooth. And if I'm lucky, unlikely, the check engine light will not come on. If it does, I'll probably have to take it in to have it actually looked at, because one of the things that was a potential was a bad coil, but I wasn't getting a bad coil reading on the diagnostic. So, but like I said, it had been 102,000, so that's why I did the plugs and the coils. They needed it anyway, and it's running so much better. And that also gave me an opportunity to make sure that the intake was completely cleaned out, and it is. So, wish me luck. And anyway, that's how you do it. I will tell you that it took me about 4 hours, but that was me doing the video and all this. So, it's a 3 hour, should be able to do it in 3 hours. And if you really focus and just burn through it, probably 2, because I also cleaned the EGR valve and all that you may or may not want to do. I do recommend it though. All right, guys, I appreciate it, and hopefully this doesn't turn out too long. Thanks for watching. If you do find it helpful, please comment, like, subscribe, and you know, if you got questions or tips, whatever, you know, feel free to ask. If I can answer, I will. If I can't, then maybe someone else can. So y'all take it easy.